The paddy fields glow a luminous green in the late afternoon sun. We are on our way to a tiny village called Kunna in violence-hit Bastar, 35 kilometers before the Sukma district headquarters and a mere 15 kilometers off the main highway that connects Sukma with Bastar's main city, Jagdalpur. Driving through the fields and the forests beyond, it's hard to believe this lush heartland is a battlefield. The journey from the highway to the village is just under 2 hours, in spite of the short distance. The dirt road is spotted with ditches made by the Maoists, locally known as Dadas, to stop police patrols from the special forces camp along the road from advancing too far inside, making our journey tougher as well. As Maoist guerrillas and security forces hunt each other, innocent villagers have become collateral damage in a bloody war. And Kunna has been in the news for the wrong reasons for the last year.
Bar bar in zoket turun it pilatin pe ma po ye ti mat bo ni kine se nimbu sa ki ti ni kine la pilla pillilla pillilla in zoket so
aur isko se dood nikala
oh se ye le kit tam ke pir tore po
Squeezing women's breasts to check if they are lactating is reportedly standard operating procedure in these parts. Since locally deployed forces believe that women who are married and have children don't become Naxals. The matter of factness, as she tells us how security men on patrol took them back to the camp and went about conducting this test, is both startling and scary.
Seven women were assaulted in this village called Kunna, deep inside the Sukma district of Bastar. In fact, village after village, stories are similar. When the forces come on combing operations inside, the boys and the men run away, fearing that they will either be arrested or killed on charges of being a Naxalite, leaving the women to bear the brunt of the onslaught themselves.
Helped by tribal leaders and activists, Kunna's women have been demanding justice.
गांव में जाते हैं जब फोर्स के लोग तो वहां कोई रहता नहीं है कहीं एक आध दो घर किसी घर में कोई महिलाएं बच्ची वाली गए तो उनको पूछे कहाँ गए तो बोले नहीं है कहाँ गए आप पूछ रहे हैं उसी पी बीच में आप क्या क्या बात हो जाता है फिर उसी में फिर ये सारी घटनाएं होती करीब करीब 12 घंटे तक लड़कियां फोर्स के कस्टडी में हैं अब फोर्स में कोई महिलाएं तो है ही नहीं अब उस बीच में जंगल में अब पूरा जंगल और ये घटना है अब वहाँ जो भी मन चाहे जैसा उनके साथ हरकत कर रहे हैं यही हुआ
सोमवार तांठिन मुलपेट बतौड़ मेला मंगुर तांठिन नरकों पोई तड़ूम पोईस मन नेखे रेतना बात बात गंद गंद वेन माँ की नसे
As we try and understand the extent of the abuse, a young man, a member of the village panchayat, is too ashamed to translate their words literally.
अभी सोमवार का है मंगलवार को पकड़ के ले गए मतलब ये बीमार है उसके बाद उसे ले जाते भी क्या क्या उसे गलत शब्द बताते बताए उसके बाद कपड़ा नई टाइप का कहीं निकाल दिए कहीं आधा रास्ता में ले जाते मतलब क्या क्या है बोल के टाइप को पूरा अपने कपड़ा को निकाल दिए
Those who highlight atrocities are regularly targeted by the state. Particularly the Inspector General of Police for the Bastar Division, SRP Kaluri. As we go to air, the Bastar police have charged sociologist Professor Nandini Sundar with the murder of a tribal man who was killed by Maoists on November 4th. The police claim she and 9 other activists incited tribals in his village in Sukma district against the police 6 months ago and that he was killed by Maoists because he had resisted. NDTV has since met the wife of the victim, Shyamnath Baghel, who says she has not filed any such FIR against either Dr. Sundar or the others. When we had spoken to her at the time of her book's release in October 2016, she had told us in Bastar, sexual violence and intimidation has become the new normal.
Right from the SP level to higher ups, they have consistently not pursued any investigation of rape cases. And this has been going on since 2005. The way Adivasis in general and women are treated, I mean, a lot of the kind of language is of describing them as animals, you know, so treating, you know, checking women's breasts to see if they're lactating is sort of a piece with this complete dehumanization of Adivasis. People don't recognize is that Adivasis don't kind of throw themselves about emotionally, weeping, crying to a public gaze. So people will talk about the most horrific things. I've been told about people being burnt alive, you know, in front of people's eyes, people, little children being killed, women being raped. They do have emotions, but they will not show it often, and it's sort of concealed.
Women like the ones in Kunna who are not raped consider themselves safe. In several villages in the neighboring Bijapur district, however, rape seems to have become the inevitable conclusion of many counterinsurgency operations. In Chhattisgarh, the distinction between local police to whom they can go and report the crimes and the special forces who are involved in counterinsurgency operations is blurred, making it even harder for the local tribal population to file complaints. The Bijapur rapes took place in October and November of 2015. For months after that, the police refused to file an FIR. That only happened with the intervention of a team from the National Commission for Women. From collecting firewood to the weekly marketing to tending to fields and managing homes and families, in villages across Bastar, it is the women who bear the weight of running a home entirely on their own, a reality that makes them both vulnerable and empowered in different ways.
What the conflict has done is destroy livelihood systems in large parts of the district, if south, you know, what used to be South Bastar, now Dantewada, Bijapur, Sukma. Nationally, 49% of Adivasi women have a body mass index less than 18.5, which means that they're actually at starvation levels. And when you look at something like Bastar, which is a conflict region, the level is likely to be much, much higher.
At the crack of dawn in Jagdalpur, lawyer Shalini Gera meets us with two young women from Bijapur. They are on their way back from the High Court in Bilaspur with a court order for their protection. The girls have filed a case against security forces, accusing them of killing six people, including a nine-year-old child, in what they claim were fake encounters.
आपको डर नहीं लगता?
नहीं, अपन डरते नहीं।
आप ही हो हिंदी बोलने वाले आपके गांव में?
नहीं, अपन लोग बोलते हैं। सब लोग गोंडी भाषा बोलते हैं। मारपीट किए वाले लोग अपन के साथ बात किए हैं सब लोग आके। फिर उन लोगों के साथ अपन बीजापुर आए थे। वहाँ आने के बाद अपन दो एक एक दो दिन रुके थे बीजापुर में, तब अपने पीछे पड़े थे पुलिस लोग। अपन फिर ये बिलासपुर कोर्ट में गए। ऐसे मारपीट करने का, अपन ऐसे आम जनता को पकड़ के मारपीट करके वर्दी पाए ना के नक्सली केस डाल रहे हैं।
Shalini Gera is escorting them to ensure that the Bijapur superintendent of police receives the order and is therefore bound to enforce it.
At this time, we are seeing in all these villages, it's only these young women who are able to do this role of facilitating the voices from the villages to come outside and be heard by courts, by authorities, etc. These are women who are slightly literate, who are Hindi speaking, and so can actually bring these stories out. And it also happens to be mainly women who can play this role, because men again get targeted as militants.